I'm Sheriff John Bunnell. In my 25 years in law enforcement, I've encountered thousands of criminals who knew everything about their victims. But I've met very few victims who know anything about criminals. This show is going to change all of that. So get ready. What you're about to see will open your eyes to the world of crime.
Okay, this appears to be a 1998 black Mercedes sedan.
The streets of LA are full of luxury cars, but this one is running from the police.
Okay, he just blew another intersection.
In the passenger seat is a rising rap star, and he's wanted for carjacking and drug charges.
This is unbelievable. He's just cruising in the wrong lane.
When officers came looking for him, the rapper hopped in his car and told his partner, "Who's the cops?"
Okay, they almost head on with a white car.
He throws a metal briefcase from the car.
He just tossed something out of the window. It looks like something metal.
Once they have some room, the Mercedes slows down and the door opens.
Someone's getting out. Okay, someone's out of the vehicle. The passenger is running down a residential street.
The rapper makes a break on foot, leaving his driver to draw the police away. But the cops will get back to him later. Meanwhile, the gleaming German auto weeds uphill, cutting across Hollywood's famous Mulholland Drive. Above, a swarm of news and police choppers track his every move.
Okay, he's now going over the 405 freeway.
The Mercedes streaks toward a clogged on-ramp, pounding and smashing his way through.
Oh, he just scraped off two cars, and now he's getting on the 405 south. Man, he's flying.
Speeds double, and so does the danger. He guns through traffic until he sees a wide open lane.
He's now in the right-hand breakdown lane. It looks like he might be exiting the freeway.
The brand new luxury car already shows the scars of this chase. But the driver risks more damage, blazing past school buses and forcing other cars out of his way. At these speeds, it's only a matter of time before something goes wrong.
There are no units in front, but about a quarter mile. Where'd he go? Where'd he go?
The Mercedes clips a pickup and bounces off the cement wall.
There he is. There he is. Zoom in. Okay, he's lost a tire. It's stuck in the wheel well.
The high-priced, high-performance import is crippled. Unable to control it, the driver grinds into the curb.
Oh, I can't believe this. He's speeding up.
Plowing the bare alloy rim into the pavement, the fugitive creates a dangerous wake of sparks and smoke.
Oh, there's no way he's going to be able to stop. Oh!
To finally stop this ruined Mercedes, it takes two more collisions.
Okay, he's out of the car. Suspect is out of the car. He's going over that fence. Okay, he's going into the Holiday Inn.
The man foolishly runs into the hotel, but it's a dead end.
Okay, officers are on the scene now.
The officers are right behind the suspect. Moments later, he's let out in handcuffs.
This is code four. Code four, it's all over.
The cops have a room of their own already for this guy. They've even sent a car. Meanwhile, other units set up a perimeter where the rap star bailed out. The fugitive rapper is found hiding in a house nearby. This time, he's not getting away. For this hood-turned hip-hopper, a black Mercedes was the symbol of his success. Thanks to his chase, his career, his car, and his life are all trashed. Greensboro, North Carolina. The man in this car has beat up his girlfriend during an angry breakup and smashed her car with a baseball bat. When deputies came, he jumped in the vehicle and ran. Now he's running at 90 miles an hour in a car with a shattered windshield. The man swerves wildly, nearly losing control. It's a wonder he can drive at all. The suspect is armed, intoxicated, and mad as hell. A time bomb ready to go off. The chase has enraged the suspect even further. He doesn't care who gets hurt.
714, we're coming up on Freeman Mill Road this time. Traffic's getting a little bit heavier.
He insanely squeezes between two cars and cuts toward an exit. At the last moment, he pulls back onto the road. But these tricks don't fool these seasoned officers. They stay right with him. More deputies join the pursuit. Pushing 100 miles an hour, the driver bets his life that he can get between the deputy and a guardrail.
Come around, John.
In the lead and overconfident, the driver veers around a car and hits an exit at nearly 70. The deputies keep right on him and close the gap. The suspect nearly wipes out. It doesn't faze him. In fact, this lunatic goes even faster, challenging the officers to keep up at nearly 120 miles an hour. But they've got the training and experience to handle it. He doesn't. The suspect tries to pass on the shoulder. He fishtails and loses control. Incredibly, no one is hit. The suspect still tries to run, but he hasn't a leg to stand on, not with a belly full of tequila. A guardrail keeps his car from rolling into traffic. The suspect thought he could beat his girlfriend and outrun the law. But after a wipeout like this, he's lucky to be alive at all.
Drop the gun, man!
These are the moments they prepare for.
Get your hand out from your coat now.
It was almost textbook.
The moments they train for.
Get out of there!
When everything they've ever learned is cops.
Requesting permission to take the unit out.
Will be put to the test.
A high-speed pursuit is a dangerous situation for any cop. But when you're chasing a suspect in the opposite lanes of traffic at 100 miles an hour, that's about as dangerous as you can get.
Chesterton, Indiana. Police set up a roadblock to catch a convicted sex offender.
Units, be advised, the suspect is Code 10, history of child molestation.
Officers report a young woman in the car. Police know her very life may depend on them. The suspect, heading west, is approaching fast. The cops are right on him. But the driver takes desperate measures to escape. As he speeds past, more cops join the chase. This is an officer's worst nightmare, chasing a suspect in opposite lanes of the freeway. Vehicles race headlong into approaching headlights at 80 miles per hour. Factor in the speed of oncoming traffic, and a collision would be like hitting a brick wall at 160. Though on-ramps have been closed, traffic is still heavy. And now officers have fog and slick roads to deal with. But the police won't let the treacherous conditions slow them down. This sexual predator is one suspect they can't let get away. To avoid another roadblock, the suspect cuts across the median again. Stationary barriers aren't working on this guy. So the police enter a rolling roadblock formation, a complex and dangerous maneuver that boxes the suspect in. He sees the trap and fights to get back in front. The lead car blocks his path. But amazingly, the suspect tears across the median a third time, just as they reach a guardrail. He's separated from police for the moment, but not for long. When the rail ends, the cops get right back on his tail, back on the wrong side of the freeway. He realizes his only chance is to get off the highway. Waiting till the last second, he veers across several lanes to make his escape. Now he's going the wrong way on an on-ramp. If someone comes around that blind curve, he's history.
Yeah, we're coming up northbound Highway 41 now.
Approaching Highway 41.
The suspect panics. He has no clue where he is. But the cops do, and they're now converging from all directions. As they punch through the fog, asphalt gives way to dirt and rubble. This may be the end of the road, but it's not the end of the pursuit. In an act of sheer desperation, he drives blindly into a cornfield. The determined cops close in.
He's gonna try to drive through.
attack. It's time to shut this guy down. One officer tries the direct approach. The suspect runs, but where does he think he can hide in a cornfield? In seconds, he's tackled by a half a dozen officers. This dangerous chase through four cities is over. Inside the vehicle, officers find a terrified teenage girl. Had police not gone the distance, the consequences could have been devastating. As for the girl's cornfield kidnapper, this convicted felon just landed himself back in prison. For a very long time.